based on scalar value or constant value series creation, the four ways of series creation based on index, based on scalar and constant value. That is, first we are giving three statements are based on integer value, that is 55 55 55. Here I am giving three type of indices, that is first one ABC, then second one 0 1 2 3, third one it is a string value, set of string value. Then the fourth statement is for this constant value is used as a string. Here I am using a string value, a scalar or constant value, and we can give any of this index value. Okay, the next, write the heading creation of series using dictionary. S1 is equal to pd dot series within bracket, within flower bracket, here pd dot series. Series is a built-in function, so start with round bracket. Okay, all the series function will start with a round bracket. Within round bracket we can use either square bracket. If we need a list, then start with square bracket. If I'm using a tuple, start with another round bracket. If we need a dictionary, start with flower bracket. Okay, so here the question is based on dictionary, so start with flower bracket. When we are writing a dictionary content, a pair is used, that is the A colon 31. This is dictionary, that is key value. A colon 31, that is dictionary content. So dictionary means it's a set of key value pairs. Here key is used as index value. There is no need of another index value. Here in the case of dictionary, the key value is used as index value, and 31, that is value, is the data value. All of you switch on the video. Switch on the video, children. Navin, Basil, Grishma, Sana, Irfan, all of you switch on the video. So here series creation using dictionary. Here a key value pair is used. Three pairs I am using here. The first pair it is A31, second pair it is B35, third pair it is C40. Okay, so here in that pair, the first value is for index and second value is for data value. Okay, so how is the output? Index value, that is A, data value 31, B 35, C 40, and I'm writing the D type also. Here D type it is int 64. Is it clear? This is series creation using dictionary. So start with round bracket because series is a function. Within that round bracket, we are creating a series using dictionary. So start with dictionary symbol, that is flower bracket. Within that flower bracket, we are using some pairs. That is, a single pair include a key and value. Here, this is the key. This key is used as index of that series. Here, A is the index value, so A will appear here. 31 is the data value, so 31 here. Okay. Is it clear, Basil? Okay, Naveen. Basil. Pavitra, is it clear, Pavitra? Okay. Then next is naming a series. How we can name the series? If I am using a name for data value, how is the syntax? Meghna, how is the syntax?
Series dot index name equal to.
That is, series dot name is equal to name. Here, what is the name of my series? Here, my series name, it is S1. Okay, so S1 dot name is equal to name. Or I'll give subject. If I want to give a heading for data value, this is for data value. For data value. If I want to give a name for data value, the syntax it is s1.name. Here I'm using s1 because I just created one series with name s1. Okay, here my series name, it is S1. If it is S2, then you just give S2.name. If it is series, series.name. Okay, so S2.name is equal to, within single quotes, give the name for that data value. This is for data value representation. If I want to give the name for index, then how is this index? Pavitra, how is this index? S2 dot. Irfan. Irfan. Okay, Amal. S2 dot?
S2 dot name dot index.
S2 dot name dot index. Okay, it is index dot name. Okay, Amal? S2 dot index dot name, which is equal to mark. Or roll number. So here, for naming, this is for index naming. This is for data value naming. So for data value naming, the syntax is s2.name, which is equal to, within single quotes, give the name. Then in the case of index naming, the syntax is s2.index.name is equal to roll number. Then write one output also based on this naming. How is the output? Here, index name, it is roll number. Roll number will appear like this. If it is 0, 1, 2, 3. Will appear here. Then data value A, B, C, D, F, G, H, I, data value. Then here name, it is subject. Then D type is equal to int 64. Okay, here the index name will appear here. Then the data value name, it will appear like this. Name colon subject comma D type is equal to int 64. You just, after writing these two statements, write this output also. This is an example after using this name attribute. Here, roll number is the index name. So index name will appear on the top of the index value, and subject is the data value name. So this data value name will appear here, bottom of the that is after all the value representation, keyword name will appear. After that colon, then your data value name, that is subject. After that, type of that value, that is here it is not int 64, it is object, because here we are using string value. So the D type, it is object. Okay, this is naming. So for naming, we are using the attribute name, and for data value naming, the syntax it is s1.name, which is equal to one string value, and for index value naming, s1.index.name is equal to one string value. Or we can give integer value also, and the output is display like this. The next is creating a series using mathematical expression. Creating a series using mathematical expression. That is S1 is equal to PD dot series. Start with round bracket, then index is equal to S1 comma S1 into 2. That is here S1 is equal to NP dot arrange any value 1 comma 10. When we are using this arrange function, which module is imported first, Ashish? Just like import pandas as PD, we want to import one more module. Which one is that? You can just imagine that is here I am using NP, then
NumPy.
Yes, it is NumPy. Okay, so first you want to import NumPy. First you want to import pandas, after that NumPy as NP, because here I am using NumPy because I am using arrange function here for set for taking a set of integer value. I'm using arrange function. If you are using arrange function, first you want to import NumPy. Okay, so s1 is equal to np dot arrange 1 comma 10 means 1 to 9 are the values here. Okay, so arrange 1 comma 10 means 1 to 9 values are assigned into s1. So here I am already used one s1. So s2 is equal to pd dot series index is equal to s1, means I'm assigning these values as index. So here it is index value, it is 1 2 3 2 9. Then this is the mathematical expression. Here what will happen? The first value of s1, it is 1, so 1 into 2, it is 2. Then second value, it is 2, 2 into 2, 4, then 3 into 2, 6, just like that, 9 into 2, 18. Then D type also. Is it clear, children? You can give s1 into 2 comma index equal to s1 also. Okay. So this is mathematical expression. Here, instead of this s1 plus 2, we can give any mathematical expression. S1 plus 2 or s1 by 2 or s1 plus 2 by 2. Any expression we can give. Yes. Any doubt, children?
No.
Okay. Here, import num by as np, s1 is equal to np dot arrange 1 comma 10, then 1, 2, 2, 9 are the values, then s2 is equal to pd dot series, index equal to s1 comma s1 into 2. So here we can give any mathematical expression. Okay, so this is series creation using mathematical expression. All of you switch on the video, children.
No.
Okay, Vidur.
Now after index, we are writing data now. So we have to write data is equal to s1 into 2.
Data is equal to
s1 into 2. Do we have to write data is equal to
here d type? You are asking about d type?
No, ma'am. In the program.
Instead of this s1 into 2, we can give data.
Data is equal to
s1. You can give data is equal to s1 into s2 also. Means it is the value. We are assigning this value to this variable data. Okay, Vidur?
Okay.
Okay. Is it clear, Hanna?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the last topic, it is creating a series using num by array. Write the heading, creating a series using num by array. How we can start? Ashish, how we can start the program?
Import n by s nd.
Import num by s np, one of the import statement. Before that, one more import statement. Which is that?
Import pandas as pd.
Okay. Import pandas as pd. Correct, Ashish. Then, how we can create an array using np? Raina?
Array is equal to np dot array.
Within bracket, you have to give some value. Okay. So within bracket, within square bracket, I am giving 1, 2, 3, 4. So here I am using array function. For that, I am using the function import statement, import num by as np. It's not nd, it is np. Okay. So, an MCQ question, one filling the blank is used here. Instead of this import statement, one filling the blanks. So, if you are using array function here, you want to import this numpy. Which statement is used for, which statement which import statement is used when we are using this array function? That is the question. So you want to import numpy. Before using this array function, you want to import numpy. And here also, dash dot array. Here, array is the built-in function. So here we start with np dot array. Okay. Then how is the series creation? Elvina, how is the series creation statement?
S1 equal to pd dot series bracket array.
Series within bracket. Here the name it is array. So you want to give the name array here. Okay. So here I'm using pd dot series array. There is no index value. Then which is the index value, Sana? Here there is no index value. Then which are the values assigned for index? Sana? All of you switch on the video, children. Navin? Amal, how is the series creation? That is, after creating the series, I'm only using this array. How is the index value?
Zero.
It is 0, 1, 2, 3. Here, there is no index value. So the index values are 0, 1, 2, 3. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, Naveen. Then these are the revision topics based on today's session, isn't it? So we can start with some MCQ questions. So any doubt, children, related with this topic, these topics? According to series creation based on dictionary or based on scalar value, then naming concept is the, then based on list, based on nested list. Okay, these are the topics related with first part revision. Okay, any doubt, children?
No.
Okay, Lydia. Okay, okay, thank you, Reina. So we can start with some MCQ questions. Did you check that MCQ question that I posted in the group based on series part? Anyone? Did you check the questions?
I'm only some.
Some, only some. Okay. You just write the question 25. I think we completed the first, which is the last question we discussed. Hanna, which is the last question? Anyone? Vidur? Just check. Just write the 25th question. Which of the following is the correct statement to access index third and fifth values using positional index for series S? Which of the following is the correct statement to access index third and fifth values using positional index for series S? And also do the 24th one. Which of the following is correct way of assigning a labeled index to series? Do it fast. Vidur completed.
Ma'am, 25th one.
What is the result of 25, Vidur?
B.
Yes, it is S of 3,5. Okay. Then write the 24th question. Which of the following is correct way of assigning a labeled index? What is labeled index? Meghna, what is labeled index?
Index.
Given a name to index, that is labeled index. Okay. All of you switch on the video, children. Navin. Okay, Navin, okay. Irfan, Pavitra, Lydia. Anthony, Basil, switch on the video. What is the result, Elvina? 24th one?
Ma'am, option C.
This one. That's good. Option C. Is it correct, Meenakshi? Option C.
I'm option D.
Option?
D.
D. D, it is okay. Here, Elvina, we are using dictionary. Here, the data value is in dictionary. If we are giving a value based on dictionary, how is the syntax, Elvina? Elvina, if you are giving some value within dictionary, how is this index?
Curly bracket.
Within curly bracket, how we can give the result?
Built-in keys.
One key value is there. After that, one colon is there. Then only we can give some value. Is it clear, Elvina?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here we are giving only integer value. There is no key value pair. Dictionary means it is a set of key value pair. So here B with some value, just like that. Okay. So if we are using dictionary inside the series function, the statement is like this. Within flower bracket, first you want to give one value, after that one colon, then another value. This is key value pair. Okay. Is it clear, Ashish?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then do this 27th one. Select the correct option to get the index preview in reverse order. In reverse order, that is, if the string is ABC, you want to print CBA. That is the question. Select the correct option to get the index preview in reverse order. Here, what is this first value? Meghna, what is this first value? According to S, we are giving three value. 1, 5, 1. Here, what is this one?
Start value.
Yes, it is start value. Then, Raina, what about the second value?
Top value.
Then, third value? Raina? It is increment value or step value. Okay. So when we are using this slicing method, three values are used. The first value, it is the start value. Second value, it is the stop value. And third one is the step value. So I want to print a string in reverse order. So just take one example. ABC is the string. Then how we can print the CBA? If I'm giving this statement, that is minus 1, 1, what is the result? You just find out like that. Then if it is minus 1, 1, 1, what is the result? Then minus 1, what is the result? Then which statement is correct? Do it fast. Donna?
Yes, ma'am.
Completed?
No, ma'am.
So if I'm giving no value in the case of this, here in this statement, there is no first value, no second value, only last value. Then how is the working, Hanna? What is the start value? If there is no value in place of start, then what is the value? It's not clear, Hannah. Here the value it is zero. Okay. If there is no start value means the start value it is zero. Okay. Then Basil. Am I audible, Basil? Amal, if there is no stop value, which is the value for that stop? If there is no start value, the start value is zero. If there is no stop value, what is the value? Anyone? Okay, Amal. Okay, no problem. Anyone? Evelyn?
Ma'am, last value.
That is total number of alphabets present in that string. Okay, that is the last value. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3 alphabets are there. So the stop value, it is total number of alphabets present in that string. Here it is 3. Indexing is starting from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3 are the index value of A, B and C. But here, if there is no stop value, the stop value it is total number of characters present in that string. If there is no start value, the start value is 0. You just write like this. If there is no start value... If there is no start value, write it, Raina. If there is no start value is zero. If there is no stop value, the stop value is total number of elements present in that string or total number of characters present in that string. Then if there is no step value, here step value is there. If there is no step value, the step value it is 1. So if there is no start value, start is 0. If there is no stop value, stop is n. That is total number of characters present in that string. If there is no step value, the value it is 1. Okay. Then which one is the correct option? Donna?
Third one.
Yes, it is third one. That is S colon colon negative 1. That is, we are starting from 0. That is, if it is A, B, C, the index values are 0, 1, 2. Okay. Here the start value is 0. So we are starting from 0. And the stop value it is N, that is 1, 2, 3. 3 is the stop value. So we are starting from 0. But here the incrementation value, it is minus 1. Okay. So the start value, it is... Start value, it is 0. So the next value, it is 0 plus minus 1. What is 0 plus minus 1? It is negative 1. Okay, this is forward indexing. In the case of backward indexing, we are starting from minus 1. So it is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So the first value it is 0 plus minus 1, it is minus 1. Then next value it is minus 1 plus minus 1, which is equal to minus 2. So after C, next value it is minus 2. The next value it is minus 2 plus minus 1, which is equal to minus 3. So minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. C, B, A is the result. Is it clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. One second.